Dear students, today we'll start second chapter, that is electrostatic potential and capacitance. First, tell me, what is electric potential? Let us consider two bodies A and B. Suppose it is body A and it is body B. Suppose A acquires a charge Q1, B acquires a charge Q2. Let Q1 be more than Q2. If these two bodies are kept in electrical contact with each other, electrical contact means either two bodies physically contact with each other or they are connected together by a conducting wire. Now tell me, from which body to which body the charge will flow? The charge will flow from A to B or from B to A? Here the charge seems to flow from A to B because A has more charge. But we have to see whether the charge will flow from A to B or B to or from B to A. Now you consider another two bodies A and B. A contains heat H1, B contains heat H2. When they are in thermal contact with each other, let H1 more than H2. Now tell me, from which body to which body the heat will flow? Whether heat will flow from A to B or from B to A? You know, whatever the heat contained by the body, it doesn't matter. Temperature determines the direction of flow of heat. Always heat will flow from a body of higher temperature to a body of lower temperature. The amount of heat doesn't determine the direction of flow of heat. The temperature determines the direction of flow of heat. Similarly, you see, here you have two containers. In container A, you have liquid up to this side, and container B, it contains liquid up to this side. When they are connected together, then from which container to which container the liquid will flow? You see, A contains less amount of liquid, B contains more amount of liquid. But you will observe the liquid will flow from A to B, because here the level of the liquid or the height of the liquid is more than that of in container B. That means the amount of liquid doesn't determine the direction of flow of liquid. Which determines the direction of flow of liquid? That is the level, that is the height. Similarly, here you see the amount of heat doesn't determine the direction of flow of heat. Which determines? Temperature. Here you see the amount of liquid doesn't determine the direction of flow of liquid. Which determines? The level or the height. Similarly, in case of two charged bodies, the amount of charge doesn't determine the direction of flow of charge. Then which determines? That is the electric potential. So what is electric potential? That is the physical quantity which determines the direction of flow of charge, electric charge. You remember, the positive charge always flows from a body of higher potential to a body of lower potential. The negative charge flows from a body of lower potential to a body of higher potential. It is your qualitative definition of electric potential. Now come to quantitative definition of electric potential. Now we will study electric potential energy. Electric potential energy. You know, electrostatic force is a conservative force. And you know, for a conservative force, the change in potential energy is equal to negative of work done by that force. Let us consider a point O. At O, you have a charge Q, source charge Q. A and B are two points in the electric field of the source charge Q. Now, here you consider a text charge Q0. You take source charge is positive and text charge is always taken as positive. Now, what is the direction of the electric force? It is positive, you have taken source charge, test charge is always positive, so it is the direction of electric force, because the force is repulsive here. To displace the charge Q0 from A to B, the work done by the electric force, that is WE, just told, the change in potential energy, that is the negative of work done by the electric force, because electric force is conservative force. Change in potential energy, that is potential energy at the final point, that is B, minus potential energy at the initial point, that is A, that is minus WE. But to displace the charge from A to B, we need external force in this direction, because electric force is in direction. To displace the charge from A to B, the charge Q0 from A to B with zero acceleration, means without any acceleration, this force must be equal in magnitude with electric force. That means magnitude of external force is equal to electric force. That means here you also see direction of electric force is towards right and external force is towards left. So you can write like this. Or F external is equal to minus F electric. Here, when you apply the external force which has same magnitude as that of electric force but opposite in direction to that of electric force, then the charge particle Q0 will move from A to B with same velocity, with zero acceleration. Then what is the net work done? Zero. That means W external is minus W electric. Means work done by the external force is equal to negative of work done by the electric force. You can write external work done, F external, F vector dot dx vector, work done is dot product of force and displacement. Here A to B is equal to negative of work done by electric force in displacing the charge from A to B. You remember, work done by the external force is equal to negative of work done by the electric force. That means here you can write W external. Therefore, UB minus UA is equal to W external. Now, the change in electric potential energy between any two points in an electric field is defined as the amount of work done by an external agent in displacing a charge from one point to the other without any acceleration. Now, if you take the point A is at infinity, if point A is at infinity, infinity means, you remember, that is outside the electric field. Outside the electric field means potential at that point, or potential energy at that point is zero. Therefore, UB minus UA, that equal to UB minus zero, that equal to UB, that equal to W external. So, what is the electric potential energy of a charge at this point B? That is the you can define like this: the electric potential energy at any point in an electric field is defined as the amount of work done by an external agent in bringing the charge from infinity to that point, to that point without any acceleration. Repeating again, the electric potential energy at any point in an electric field is defined as the amount of work done by an external agent in bringing the charge from infinity to that point without any acceleration. Now come to electric potential difference. It is point O, here you have the charge Q, this point A, this point B, you place a test charge Q0, just told electric force in this direction, external force in this direction, and from A to B, the amount of work done in displacing the charge Q0 from A to B, that is your potential energy difference, UB minus UA. It is the work done by the external agent in displacing the charge Q0 from A to B. To displace, you need positive charge. What is the amount of work done? That is WEXT divided by Q0. This equal to potential difference between these two points. So, what is electric potential difference? Electric potential difference between any two points in an electric field is defined as the amount of work done by an external agent in displacing a unit positive charge from one point to the other without any acceleration. That equal to W external, you know, that is UB minus UA, that is change in potential energy divided by Q0. If you take A point is at infinity, A is at infinity means outside the electric field, that means potential at that point is 0. therefore VB minus VA that equal to VB minus 0 that equal to VB that equal to VC. Therefore V is equal to W external by Q0. So electric potential, how can we define electric potential at any point in an electric field is defined as the amount of work done by an external agent in bringing a unit positive charge from infinity to that point without any acceleration. Now, what is the SI unit of electric potential? It is the definition of electric potential. Now, what is the SI unit of electric potential? SI unit, that is volt. Therefore, 1 volt that equal to 1 joule divided by 1 coulomb. How can you define electric potential of 1 volt? The electric potential at any point in an electric field is said to be 1 volt if 1 joule of work is done by an external agent in bringing 1 coulomb of charge from infinity to that point without any acceleration. Repeating again, the electric potential at any point in an electric field is said to be 1 volt if 1 joule of work is done by an external agent in bringing 1 coulomb of charge from infinity to that point without any acceleration. CGS units. There are two units in CGS. One is your ESU of electric potential or start volt. One start volt that equal to W work CGS unit or divided by 1 start coulomb. Similarly, EMU of electric potential or up volt. 1 up volt that equal to 1 arc by 1 half coulomb. Now come to dimension of electric potential. Dimension that is V is equal to W by Q. Electric potential dimension, W dimension, that is M1, L2, T minus 2 divided by charge dimension A1, T1, that is M1, L2, T minus 3, A minus 1. The dimension of electric potential is, this is the dimensional formula, M1, L2, T minus 3, A minus 1. Dimensions are 1, 2, minus 3, minus 1 in terms of mass, length, time and current respectively. In the next class, we will learn about electric potential due to point charge.